developing soft-bodied robots, and there are three important things to know about these robots. First, their bodies are made out of soft silicone, and they can bend and twist because of that. They're also inherently safe to be around. Second, because of their body's capability to bend and twist, these robots are capable of very compliant motion, and they are also capable of very rapid, agile maneuvers, which pushes the envelope on what machines can do today. And thirdly, the robots are self-contained and autonomous. In other words, we can package the power source, the computation, and the actuation and sensing needed for these robots to deliver their motions.
Traditionally, soft robots have been either self-contained or capable of high performance, but not both. So specifically, in our lab, we want to achieve both of those goals simultaneously in one machine. Currently, a soft robot has two parts. One, a little bit smaller, is the rigid part, where we store all the supporting hardware. And the second part, a little bit larger, is the soft body, where all the continuous natural movement happens. And so when we thought about it, a fish made sense. It has a very similar structure. In the head of the fish, where the brains are held, it's a little bit more rigid. But in the rear of the fish, where the undulatory motion happens, it's quite soft and compliant. This is our soft robot fish. Like we said, it has a soft body here in green and the supporting hardware up front. And the way this fish works is it stores fluid on board in the form of a gas and then releases this gas through a series of pipes and valves into the body. And if you think about it, it's very similar to blowing up a balloon. In that case, your mouth would be the pressure source and the balloon would be the body actuator. And basically, by inflating and uninflating different parts of the body, we can get it to undulate. What's special about this fish is that it has its brains on board too. So if I, from my computer, tell the fish to move forward, a signal is sent wirelessly through the water to the brains, and then the brains tell the hardware what to do in order to move forward.
Biological fish use the escape maneuver, or the C-turn, to escape prey. And they do these maneuvers very fast, in on the order of 100 milliseconds. Our robot fish is also able to execute the escape maneuver at the same speed, on the order of 100 milliseconds.
The fact that our fish can perform an escape maneuver is really important for the field of soft robotics. It shows that soft robots can be both self-contained and capable of high performance. The maneuver is so fast and it's got such high body curvature that it shows soft robots might be more capable than hard robots in some tasks.